Thank you, my friends, my fans are there. You are most recognized. You are most recognized. This is the Convertant TV. Please do subscribe to watch and hear and listen to more of our program. We love you. We love you. Keep watching. Keep watching. Keep.
My name is Favor. Subscribe to our channel. We love you. We love you. Keep watching.
Close for 30 minutes because of the deliverance now. we had to extend it because we believe that until the sister or the brother is not chatting fire again, the spirit has gone. Right? The spirit has gone. The truth is that we're not supposed to use 30 minutes for deliverance. You understand? We're not supposed to use 5 minutes for deliverance. Deliverance is not only about somebody fall under power. Deliverance does not mean that you must cry, or you must begin to scatter chairs, or you must begin to fight the ushers, even tear the pastor cloth. And just pray we don't see those kind of deliverance here one day. Tear my cloth.
Go and buy it.
Before you buy it, you so that you know that it's not spirit, it's not the Holy Spirit, it's not evil spirit that is manipulated. When you slap somebody, then when you see the person's back, I think 2003, 2004, in Lagos, we went. In fact, every member in that church, they are all prophets and prophetess. And in our ministry, we don't, Pastor Chris don't need to see vision like that. So the man said he's going to do something that you will receive fire in your hand and your hand will be shaking like this. Do you understand? Your hand will be shaking. I said, okay. But the pastor said, take it. I was shaking my hand. And my friend that invited me to the church was looking at me. I was shaking. I know it's not fire. It's not fire at all. I was just shaking the hand. So when you are shaking your hand, usher will come and take you to the altar. And there is a rope. Two people, once somebody is here, another person is here, they hold the rope. And when you get to that rope, you see people that maybe they really can't defy, I don't know. They will be shaking their hand. Even. But when you get to that rope, I see. They say, Mr. Mambo. You understand? So there are things like that. You see people, that's why you must be, so that you will not just go lose your strength over somebody that is just forming what he's doing. Pastor, pray. And when I notice that if I'm not careful, I can lose my neck, I fall down. It is not anointing that for me. No. They want to kill me. You are praying for somebody, you press my head, pressing my back, and I notice I'm going. If I don't fall, because I don't want to end up like that fraud in America. I have to fall down. Then when I fell down, the pastor now leave me and say, you see, it could have been something else. In fact, I could have lost my neck. Go, what is going on? You are casting. Praise God. Prophecy is something that we war. We don't wait. I say, no, I'm waiting for prophecy. No, you don't wait. You enter into prophecy. Even as I'm preaching now, you can enter into your own prophecy. That's when you are preaching message, when message is going on, when you are focused and your spirit is at alert, you can pick something from the message that will guarantee your deliverance. You don't even need somebody to lay hands on you. You don't even need prophecy. Just from the word, you are hearing it and you are concentrated. There is no distraction in your spirit. You can pick something from the preaching that guarantees your deliverance. Church, the devil are not supposed to put sickness on your body. They don't have the right. But we allow them to creep into our life by acceptance. Anything I see, I take her. I will take my life the way I see her. Then you are actually opening door to demons. Gradually, the door opened. Small, until it became what? So even demon in America will just fly from America and enter you because the door is wide open. There is no security. Bible says, so guide your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. How do you guide your heart? You know, many of us, you speak English and you don't understand the English that you are speaking. That's a problem. That's why when you speak English, use your own language to interpret it so that you can understand very well. Guide your heart. If you must guide your mouth. It is your mouth. Many of us today, your problem is not the devil, it's not even the witch, it is your mouth. What you say, what you profess, It is what is affecting your life, what you profess, what you believe. What you believe. And I believe today, every agenda of the enemies over your life shall be terminated today.
Amen.
Shall be terminated.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Acts chapter number 6, verse 6. The last one before we close. Says service is 1 hour. So we don't exceed 1 hour. Whom they set before the apostles. And when they had prayed, they laid their hands on them. When they had what prayed, they laid their hands on them. By the laying up of hands today, if there is anything that is not of God, if the enemy that marked you four times dead, it shall be reversed.
Amen.
If they have marked you for disappointment, it shall be reversed.
Amen.
If they have marked you for mockery, for you to live a life of mockery. No, there are people that live a life of mockery. People don't bring about a glory. What is funny? They're not. That one. That is in what? Mockery. Mockery state. State of emergency. Your life is in a state of mockery. They don't see you as made your life miserable. Today it shall be reversed.
Amen.
And the Bible says, in the day of his power shall his people be willing.
Mm.
We are in the last day. We are in the days of his power. Don't be apologetic. That's one of the life that we live as a Christian. Even come up purging, you apologize. You apologize to fear. You have become so apologetic that the devil mess with you. They slap you blue and black, left and right, back and front. You mean nothing to them. When you are praying, they say, don't mind. We must not give our enemies chance to rule over us. After today, by the force of heaven and by the finger of Jehovah, anything that is not planted by God is about to be uprooted in your life.
Amen.
If you plant sickness in your body, that sickness is about to be uprooted.
Everywhere
you go, you face rejection. Do you know that if people don't value